August 2nd, the destroyer Maddox reported it was attacked by a North Vietnamese patrol boat. It was an act of aggression against us. We were in international waters. I sent officials from the Defense Department out, and we recovered pieces of North Vietnamese shells that were clearly identified as North Vietnamese shells from the deck of the Maddox. So there was no question in my mind that it had occurred. But in any event, we didn't respond. Two days later, the Maddox and the Turner Joy, two destroyers, reported they were attacked.
Where are these torpedoes coming from? Well, we don't know. Presumably from these unidentified craft.
There were sonar soundings, torpedoes had been detected, other indications of attack from patrol boats. We spent about 10 hours that day trying to find out what in the hell had happened. At one point, the commander of the ship said, "We're not certain of the attack." Another point, they said, "Yes, we're absolutely positive." And then finally, late in the day, Admiral Sharp said, "Yes, we're certain it happened." So I reported this to Johnson, and as a result, there were bombing attacks on targets in North Vietnam. Johnson said, "We may have to escalate. I'm not going to do it without congressional authority." And he put forward a resolution, the language of which gave complete authority to the president to take the nation to war, the Tonkin Gulf Resolution. Now, let me go back to the August 4th attack.
Well, apparently, been at least nine torpedoes in the water. All missed.
Yeah.
No, I don't. Wait a minute. I'm not so sure about this number of engaged.
Right.
We'd have to check it out here. He said many of the reported contacts and torpedoes fired appear doubtful. Freak weather effects on radar and overeager sonarmen may have accounted for many reports.
Okay, well, I'll tell Mr. Nightmare this.
That's the best I can give you, Dave. Sorry. It does appear now that a lot of these torpedo attacks were from the sonarmen, you see. And they get keyed up to a thing like this. Everything they hear on the sonar is a torpedo.
You're pretty sure there was a torpedo attack, though?
Oh, no doubt about that. I think. No doubt about that.
No, it was just confusion. And events afterwards showed that our judgment that we'd been attacked that day was wrong. It didn't happen.
I'm a lineman for the county, and I drive the main road, searching in the sun for another overload. I hear you singing in the wire, I can hear you through the whine, and the Wichita lineman is still on the line. I know I need a small vacation, but it don't look like rain. And if it snows, that stretch down south won't ever stand the strain. And I need you more than want you, and I want you for all time. And the Wichita lineman is still on the line. And I need you more than want you, and I want you for all time. And the Wichita lineman is still on the
love. trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying how do you do. They're really saying I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. Like much more than I ever knew, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful.
Here in my hands, give me one. Hello YouTube, Danny here, and you're watching Red Pill Production, the show that brings you all the news and information and lets you decide. Now on to our Did You Know segment. Did you know that it was a false flag attack which commenced the U.S. to open warfare against North Vietnam? It was the Gulf of Tonkin incident, which was said to have occurred on August 4, 1964, as another sea battle where North Vietnam torpedo boats had allegedly attacked the U.S. ships. It was this attack in which President Lyndon B. Johnson was able to procure the authority to assist any Southeast Asian country whose government was considered to be jeopardized by communist aggression. The problem with this fable is just that. Nothing happened on August 4th. There were no North Vietnam torpedo boats and clearly no attack which had taken place. In 2005, the declassified documents stating clearly that this was a staged false flag attack as a pretext to war with North Vietnam. Please visit NSA's website where you can too find this information for yourself. Until next time, check out this clip.
And now the Gulf of Tonkin incident. In the summer of 1964, President Lyndon Baines Johnson needed a pretext to commit the American people to the already expanding covert war in Southeast Asia.
Three communist PT boats attacked an American destroyer off the coast of Vietnam yesterday, and today President Johnson's response was hard and tough.
To any armed attack upon our forces, we shall reply. To any in Southeast Asia who ask our help in defending their freedom, we shall give it.
In November of 2001, the LBJ Presidential Library and Museum released tapes of phone conversations with the President and then Defense Secretary Robert McNamara, where they openly discussed plans to use the staged Gulf of Tonkin incident as a pretext to expand the war. Then, in late 2005, the National Security Agency declassified its own official history of the Gulf of Tonkin and admitted that intelligence agency officers had deliberately skewed the intelligence and claimed that Vietnamese patrol boats had attacked U.S. destroyers on August 4, 1964, when in reality they had done nothing, even while being fired on by U.S. forces. Congress then authorized the Gulf of Tonkin Resolution. The Tonkin lie paved the way for 58,000 American deaths and over 1.5 million dead Vietnamese.
As always, please post your comments and opinions in the comments section below. And remember to support us and stay connected by subscribing. And until next time, if you say and do nothing, you have said and done everything.